Yes. My dear students, my dear little stars, welcome back. I cordially invite you for the fourth session. Please, before I open this session, I humbly request you, please, if you should have understood the session number 3, verbs. If you have understood the concept of verbs, then only you can understand this concept. Today I am going to teach you two topics. How many topics? Two topics. One is types of verbs. Another one, in the same session itself, types of sentences. Please, my dear students, care for my words. English will care for you. Otherwise, everything will become puzzle and confusing. Please, I humbly request you, go back, learn the concept of verbs very well. Later only you can understand this concept, types of verbs. What is a verb? It is explained in the session number 3. I am going to explain types of verbs and types of sentences in this session number 4. Okay, now I hope I am comparing to your 10th standard. I hope that you are learning so much in our subject. I am very happy. By staying at home itself, you are learning English excellently. I am so happy indeed, my dear little stars. Today, I am going to teach you the first concept out of two in this session is types of words. I don't take those all rules which can be found in the grammar book. My method, my rules, my techniques are totally independent. Okay. Now, how many types of verbs are there? I will say only two. That is enough. Once more. According to the need of first PUC and second PUC. Once more, whatever I am going to teach you now onwards, it will be helpful to you for both first year, second year. Not only for PUC, it is important in your life for in the degree level also. Please follow my teaching. Types of verbs, two. What are those two? One is main verbs, second is helping verbs. Once more. First one is main verbs, second one is helping verbs. It is enough. How many types of main verbs are there? Three types of main verbs. How many types of helping verbs are there? Three types. It is enough. Don't follow, don't recall those all 10th standard days. Those days are unnecessary. We must learn English verbs in this style, method or path. Now, types of verbs 2, types of main verbs 3, types of helping verbs 3. You remember, it is enough. My dear little stars, learn this concept well. Now, what are main verbs? I have taught this one in my previous session itself. Types of main verbs are 3, V1, V2, V3. Present tense, past tense, past participle. This is the game changer. Yeah, gone, V1, V2, V3, present tense, past tense, not future tense, past participle. Future tense means will plus V1, future tense. Present tense, past participle, again come back, will plus V1 is called future tense. That is enough. You don't have to memorize anything. You don't have to practice a lot of things in gate. Just prepare for the teaching. You will learn everything in gate. Next one. This is important. If you can learn this concept, you are entering into the first PUC. Exactly. Today onwards, you are my first PUC real stars. Please understand. Now onwards, I respect you as my first PUC students. Prior, these three sessions have helped you to come to this stage itself. ओके नाउ ऑनवर्ड्स बी अलर्ट बी कॉशियस बी इंटरेस्टेड सो मच प्लीज नाउ हेल्पिंग वर्ब्स आर थ्री टाइप्स आई एम टेकिंग यू टू द हायर लेवल हेल्पिंग वर्ब्स आर थ्री टाइप्स व्हाट आर दोस थ्री टाइप्स फॉर योर काइंड इंफॉर्मेशन नाउ ऑनवर्ड्स वी विल टीच दी थ्री My two colleagues also, myself also, will teach in this style. What? Be form, have form, do form. Present tense, past tense. That's all. We will never say write young, write is. No. That is totally different. Our style is totally different compared to other styles. It is why. Helping verbs are three types. First one, be form, helping verbs. Second one, have for helping verbs. Third one, do for helping verbs. In your first usage and in your second usage, we adapt, we apply, we take this system itself. We want B2, B form present tense, have form present tense, do form helping. Do form, that's all. We don't say those are words in a full manner. Now, once more, helping verbs are three types. Be form, have form, do form. You can take this one in any order. Do form, have form, be form, or be form, do form, have form. It is left to you. It is not a rule or condition to you. But if you learn in this order to understand, to add be form or have form to this list, it will become easier. It is right. My dear students, learn in this order. Be form, have form, do form. Do form must be pushed to the last stage. It is convenient for you. Now, please catch. Catch my teaching. Be form helping verbs are five words. No, I won't say five types. No. Five words. There are five helping verbs under the category of be form. That's it. Okay, now, my dear stars, have understood? There are five helping verbs under be form helping verbs. Next, there are three helping verbs under the category of have form helping verb. I won't say there are three types. No. I don't like to commit silly mistakes. Do form helping verbs means there are three. So, 3 + 3 + 5. Here, 3. Main verbs are three types. Helping verbs are three types. Remember, it is like I have mentioned here. Two types of verbs, three types of main verbs, three types of helping verbs. That's all. You don't have to memorize anything in at our college. It is like, please understand, 2 + 3 + 3. Two types of verbs, three types of helping verbs. Main verbs are three types. And helping verbs are three types. Helping verbs. Now I will explain. Under the be form, helping verbs are young, is, are, present tense. Once more, be form helping verbs young, is, are, present tense. Here I will give you one extra information. What is it? It is called present tense be form helping verb. This is important. You learn in this order. Young is our be form present tense helping verb. Once more. Young is our be form helping verb present tense. Or be form present tense helping verb. I don't want you to follow any rule. No problem. What is important? Be form helping verb present tense. Or be form present tense helping verb. Once more. Be form present tense helping verb. That is enough. Be form present tense helping verb. Here, was verb. Again, here is a great mistake. It should be pronounced as verb. But so many students are found by me that they are saying well. I don't pronounce this word as well. No, it is pronounced as one. Well, was verb past tense. How to understand was verb or be form past tense helping verbs? Once more, was verb be form past tense helping verb. Next one, overall 5 words are there. have form helping verbs. Have, has, have form present tense helping verbs. Once more. Have, has, present, have form present tense of helping verbs. Had, it is applicable to all past tense. Had, this have form past tense helping verb. Next one. Do form helping verb. New concept. You have come to know this one in my previous session itself. Now I am adding one more. Do form helping verbs. Do, does, present tense, do form helping verb. Do form present tense helping verbs are do, does. Did is do form past tense helping verb. That's all. You practice this one. You must note down these all words in your notebook itself, please. If you can understand this concept, later only you can understand types of sentences. File your kind information, my dear stars. Please practice this one. Don't jump. Don't run into next session. You stop the video now itself. Note down these all things. Practice this one. Store this information in your mind. Later, what I am going to teach in this session itself, types of sentences could be understood. I promise you. Please, if you have not understood this one, the next topic will become difficult for you. Please understand. I am sincerely requesting you, my dear stars, understand this one thoroughly. Become thorough now, later it will become easier. Please, next one. If you can understand types of sentences, later only you can understand question tags. If you can understand question tag, you can understand how to set WH questions and helping this will be formed helping verb questions. Types of questions can be understood. It is by my dear stars, it is your duty. Please understand this one so thoroughly. Whenever we ask you to say be formed, tell the words means you must be ready to say all yam is are. How to understand? Be formed, yam is are. Present tense, be formed. Was well, past tense, be formed. Have formed, have has, have formed, present tense. Had, have formed, past tense. What is singular, what is plural, later. There is no time for me to explain these all from that level. My colleagues will help you in the classroom. Now, do form, do, does, present tense, now form, helping verb. Did, past tense, do form, helping verb. You are whether you are going to memorize or whether you are going to practice this one. It is left to you. Please, once more, practice, understand these all things. Later only you can understand the topic number 2 of the day in this session is types of sentences. Okay, my dear students, understand this one thoroughly. I will teach you types of sentences. There are so many funny and new things under that types of sentences. I will explain you and please note this one, note down in your notebook and practice this one very well. And I will start now. Second topic of the day is types of sentences. Okay. My dear stars, welcome back. I am going to teach you the concept number 2 in the same session 4. 4.1 types of verbs. 4.2 types of sentences. You practice this one very, very well. You will be in advanced level. Please. Now, how many types of sentences are there? So many people will say there are 4, 3, 5, 6. Everything will be confusing. I don't follow this one forever. That is over. Now, types of sentences. They will say declarative sentence, imperative sentence, exclamatory sentence, and that one, this one. We don't want those all unnecessary education. Now, types of sentences are 3. That is, In the second year, you will learn fourth one, exclamatory sentence. We will teach you exclamatory sentence. In second PUC, exclamatory learning, exclamatory sentences unnecessary in this first PUC. Now, it is the base. My dear stars, learn slowly. Become jet car guardy, don't become jet aeroplane. Please. Types of sentences 3. Now, I am going to teach you with the examples under present tense. Understand? Each and every word, sentence, explanation must be caught, learned by you. Please. Types of sentences 3. It is enough. I am going to teach you present tense sentences. Please. Okay. Now, what are those three sentences? One is positive sentence. Second one is negative sentence. Third one is interrogative sentence. Once more. First one, positive. Second one, negative. Third one, interrogative. Now, positive sentence means yes. That's all. Positive means yes. Negative means no. Negative means no or not or never. Negative sentences. Interrogative sentence means yes or no. Okay. Nenu college hogutiya? Haudu. Positive. Nenu college hogutiya? Illa. Negative. Nenu college ge hogutiya? Yes or no? Hauda alva. Haudu, alla, hauda, alva. I don't feel that, oh, sir is not saying, where are you going, why are you going, it will take place in the next stage only. Until now, first understand, from 1 to 9, it is better to learn, not from 9 to 1. Now, haudu, alva, hauda, alva. It is enough. Types of questions. Yes or no and WH questions. It will be talked later. It is unnecessary now. Now understand. Now, first one, I take a pen. Second one, I am taking a pen. I have taken a pen. Once more, I take a pen. I am taking a pen. I have taken a pen. Do you expect me? I will teach the answer directly. No. I will give you some platform now. I will give you some base. First of all, don't learn answers immediately. Slowly, stage by stage, gradually. Now, first one, what is this subject? What is this even? Living. What is this subject? What is this be form helping one? Once more. What is this? We learn. What is this? Be form helping verb present tense. Once more. M means be form helping verb present tense. What is the word taking? What is this one? V1 plus ing. Learn in this order. Don't practice in any other method or order or any trick. This is more than enough. Now, what is this subject? What is this? Have form helping verb present tense. Have form helping verb present tense. Be form helping verb present tense. What is this? Be. Have form plus be. Be form plus V1 ing. V1. Yes. Once more. V1. Be form. V1 plus ing, have form plus V3. Yes. This is. I take a pen. Nanu tegidu kolluttene. I am taking. Nanu tegidu kollutta iddene. I have taken. Nanu tegidu kondittene. Well, you have learned this one very well. I know that one very well. Next. Now, advanced learning will take. I will give you one example. How funny! Finally, we have learned English. I am saying now, I am Mr. Victor. Okay, my name is Victor. Okay, fine. Now, how badly, how wrongly we have understood English until now, I will expose. Now, I am Mr. Victor, it is called positive sentence. Now, what is the negative, what is the interrogative question sentence? I am Mr. Victor, shall I come to you, shall I ask you, am I Victor? How should I ask you? Am I Victor means, do you want me to recognize me? Don't I know my name? This way, we have learned English in a blind path, in a wrong manner. We are going to refine correct, best, not best English. Now, I will explain. Once more, we will B form plus B1 ING, now form B1 plus B3. Now, correct learning begins from this second, from this minute, from this day itself. Now, I am taking a pen. First of all, we will learn negative sentence. Before I start explaining negative sentence and interrogative sentence, I will give you one rule, one law, two rules, just I take a pen, I not take a pen. You take a pen? Question mark. Once more. I take a pen, I not take a pen, you take a pen? Question mark. Anybody can understand that so easily. Wow, 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 wow. What super English. Huh? I take a pen. I not take a pen. Naan thakala. You take a pen. Ni thakonja. Is it correct English? Not at all. It is why, my dear students, I will write the rule number one. Note down in your book. Any negative or interrogative sentence must take two words. Rule number one. Please understand. Now, one word. You are my real first PUC stars. Please understand. Care for my teaching, please. Sincerely requesting you. Because if you speak English excellently, if you speak English correctly, first I will feel happy, your parents also will feel happy, and your life will become so super. Please. Any negative or interrogative sentence must take two words. It is the first to do. Including myself. Nobody can create any negative sentence, any interrogative sentence without two words. But I know how to break each and every rule in this English language. I know each and every rules. I know how to break those rules also, which are given in any you take Ben and Martin, any English grammar, any grammar book. I know how to break the rules of English. But it is not my job to teach you those all things. What is my job? Learn this one. Well, now.
Third, sir.
We must understand that any negative or interrogative sentence must have two verbs. What are those two verbs? It is important. It will change your total learning concepts. First, what type of verbs should be there? One helping verb plus one main verb. You don't go to any other topic. Whatever I say, you follow. One helping verb, one main verb. There may be so many different sentences, different methods. It is unnecessary for you. Whatever I say, you follow this one strictly. Yes. One is helping work, one is labor. Understood? Once more I say, please catch it. Any negative sentence, any interrogative sentence must have, must take two verbs. Two also helping verbs are, there are chances. I won't go to those level. It is unnecessary for you. One helping verb, one main verb must be there in the negative sentence, in the interrogative sentence. It is the fundamental law in English. Remember this sentence forever. Then there is no single error or flaw or mistake in your writing, speaking or learning also. Once more, please. Any negative sentence, any interrogative sentence must take two verbs. One is helping verb, one is main verb. It is the law of English. Then, how many verbs are here? Only one. Then can we say that it is a negative sentence? No. You catch this one now. I am so happy that you have understood this concept. We must prove that this sentence is a wrong. You may say blindly, it is a wrong sentence. If I put you question, why this sentence is wrong, means can you understand? Can you explain? It is why every word, every line is important. These are the secrets in English. We must know these are things in the beginning. Later we can improve our language, English language. So, I do not take a pen, there is no helping word. It is why it is not a negative sentence. Here, you take a pen, it is a positive sentence. Even though I have written question mark, it is not a question at all. Why? There is no helping word at all. If there is no helping word, it is not at all an interrogative question sentence. Interrogative sentence means question sentence. How many types of questions? Yes or no? Those are things will take place in the next few minutes. Now, it is not at all negative sentence. Why? There is no helping word. There is no helping word. It is why? Both are wrong, wrong, wrong. It is also wrong. It is also wrong. It is the rule. What you must understand. Now it will improve your language. Now, I will explain how to change one positive present tense into negative sentence present tense. How to change into interrogative sentence? I will explain. Be ready and take your notebook also. Be ready to note down what the sentence is. I am going to write now. Now, before I teach you how to change this one into negative, I will take this one first. You can change this one into negative very easily. See, I am taking, first you note down, I am not taking a pen. Negative. Once more. I am taking a pen. I am not taking a pen. You are so happy that whatever you know, I am writing. You may think that, I know this answer. Before sir could tell this answer. Very good. I am also so happy that you have written this negative sentence in advance. But my point is not your point. My point is so different. If you can understand this explanation, later only you can understand this one and this one. Now, first question. What is unnecessary? No role of the subject. What is this before? What is this B1 plus ING? Before understanding the answer, first I will explain what is the question. After writing the answer, I will explain why we should use this answer only, why there is no other answer. Now, it is called helping verb, it is called main verb. You write or put or insert, insert not between helping verb and main verb, it is called a negative sentence. For your kind information, write not between helping verb and helping verb and main verb, it is called a negative sentence. For your kind information, my dear students, if you are thorough, if you are strong in changing one positive into negative, later only you will become perfect in changing one positive sentence directly into interrogative sentence. Otherwise, it is highly impossible. If I say it is impossible, means it is impossible for ever for anyone. Yeah. Now, I am not writing a pen. Wow. Easily you have understood. Very good. Now, I have taken a pen. You can say the answer very easily. How? Rule is ruler. If I say one rule, means if that rule is forever, wherever you go, that rule is applicable. Okay. Right. Not between helping verb and main verb. It is the negative sentence. Before understanding this answer, you must understand, please. If you don't understand the line what I am going to say now, it will become confusing there. Careful, alert. Whatever I say, it must be understood by you on the spot in this minute itself. It is called the form, it is called V1 plus ING, it is called helping verb, it is called main verb, it is why not means whatever, it is a negative sentence. Okay. Next, here also, you write have. Next word, not. I have not taken a pen. Here also, see, helping verb, main verb. Nobody can change this rule. But there are some sentences I can break the rules. It is unnecessary. It is called helping verb. Have form. Please understand. Have form, helping verb, and taken. It is called the present tense. Nano, tegedukondu illa. Nano, tegedukondu illa. Enough. You don't feel that, sir, I did not teach this one, I take a pen, how to say negative sentence, I have not forgotten. Okay, now, real game begins. This concept is totally different. Now, I will say, rule number one, there must be two words. One is helping verb, one is main verb, okay, it is okay. But now, it is not okay with this one. Now tell me, how to change this positive sentence into negative sentence, please? I request you, care for my teaching so deeply, so carefully for just 10 minutes. Then everything will become clear for you, please. Now, what is this P1? How many verbs are here? I take a pen. How many verbs are here? Only one. What kind of verb? I won't say those all things again and again. V1 is there. That's all. When V1 is there, how many verbs are here? Only one. But how many verbs should be there in the negative sentence? Two. Then what is present? V1. Main verb. What is absent? Helping verb. Well, then two verbs must be there now. Then how to add now? I will explain now. Now, how it is, what is this? V1. What is missing? Helping verb. Then tell me how to find out the helping verb for this one. Some students, so many, all of you know the answer, but I want you to prove that your answer is correct. I will prove why I am writing that particular answer. There is no second answer to this particular I take a pen. My dear students, it is the main thing what we must understand. We are saying, that is negative sentence, okay, but why that sentence is correct, why that sentence is not correct, we must prove why, give the reason. Now, I will take. बी फॉर्म बी वन प्लस आई एच ए हाउ वन प्लस बी थ्री टू वर्ब्स आर हियर बट हियर ओनली वन वर्ब वेयर इज अदर वन सेकंड वर्ब इज नॉट देयर देन फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई विल राइट वन रूल ऑन द बोर्ड नाउ व्हाट इज द रूल इफ वी वन प्लीज write it down my dear little stars of Narayan Guru College write this rule rule number 3 we want take is there helping verb is do helping verb we want plus yes takes is there in the positive sentence the helping verb is does we do if took is there in the main sentence you use did once more did first note down this rule later on you start concentrating on this teaching note down rule number 3 B1 if take is there in the positive sentence in the negative sentence we must make do as the helping verb we are learning we are taking the extra word from our language okay na we want take is there do is the helping verb if we want plus yes any verb it may be rule is rule plus means you are adding no minus means what minus means you are deducting no multiplication means rule rule Forever it is a rule. Similarly, this is the rule that we want is there, take, or give, or see, or love, whatever that we want is there in the sentence. You must use do as the helping verb. Rule number 3, first topic. Second topic. We want plus yes, takes main verb. We want plus yes is there in the sentence. You must use does as a helping verb. Takes, gives, loves, runs, smiles, looks, sleeps, eats, reads, whatever we want plus yes is there, you must use does as a helping verb to change one positive sentence into interrogative. So, negative sentence or positive sentence into interrogative sentence. Memorize. My dear stars, understand. Otherwise, everything will become new. If you have understood this concept, everything will become beautiful to you forever. Next, we do. Do. You use did as helping verb. This is the law of English forever, any day. It is by give, do. Gives, does. Give, did. Helping verbs. Take your own time. Note down these all rules. Later, I will change this positive sentence into negative sentence. Now, I is I. Next word, I am not taking. Helping verb is there. What is the helping verb? First of all, it is called be one. What is the helping verb? You know it better now. I am so happy that you have caught my point. Very well. Good luck. Keep on learning in this manner. I feel very proud of you, my dear stars. What is the helping word? Do. Very good. What is the negative word? Not. What is the V1? As it is. I do not take it. Finish. 25% of your learning is over by understanding this concept itself. Very good. Next. For example, I see the movie. What is the negative sentence? I do not see the movie. I give a pen. I give you a pen, but I don't have much time in it. I do not give. is called negative math. Please, if you are not understood, my dear stars, go back and replay, understand this one. If you don't understand this concept, go back and play this video, understand it thoroughly, fully, to the maximum level. Later, you can understand what are the interactive sentences. Next, for example, I will give you another rule. Rule number 4. Please, these all rules are important. No one, including myself, can change this rule because law of English. Those masters have created these rules. We have to follow. It is correct. Now, rule number 4. In case of do, otherwise I will explain one example. And it is correct. In case do or does or did. Once more, what is this form? Do form. Do form, helping words, present tense of past. Okay, please understand. Everything is new to you, everything is important. This way, my dear students, learn this one. Do or does or did, if there is in the negative sentence or interrogative sentence, you must use. Once more, understand my line. If in the negative, in the positive sentence or negative sentence or interrogative sentence, do or does or did is there in any sentence. Once more I say, whether it is a positive sentence or negative sentence or interrogative sentence, do or does or did must take only P1. It is the law of English. We never should use V1 plus S, V3, V2, never in your dream also. Do or does or did plus V1, you see, have plus V3, correct? V1 plus V3 or V1 plus V1 IIJ. How this rule is applicable? Here also, this rule is applicable, my dear stars. My dear stars, understand. If you don't understand this rule, again your sentence will become wrong. Do or does or did is there in any type of sentence, positive, negative, interrogative, you must use V1. See? Do form. It is called what? Do form will mean what? What is this called? V1 only. I will explain with two more examples, then you will understand how to understand this concept. Now, rule number 4 is over. Now, he comes early today. Okay? He comes early. Otherwise, you may not understand. He comes to college. He comes to college. He is your friend of our college only. Why? He comes to college. If he comes to the college, means for doing other work, non-teaching works. It is why. He comes to college. Understand? V1 plus S. Yes. It is called V1. V1 is here. V1 plus S. Now take subject as it is. He. What is the helping word? V1 plus S means does. Yes. V1 plus S means does. It is by he, does. What do I write? Now, important thing. After writing this sentence for 100 times, after listening this one for 100 times, while writing automatically, it is your habit for 10 years, you will write again wrong sentence. It is why to learn words, your English must be refined in the my dear stars. He does not come. That is enough. He does not come. See, rule number 1. V1 plus S plus V1. Please. V1 plus S plus V1. Does means what? Do form. Here it is not V1. Does form a helping verb? Does form helping verb? Does. Why? When comes V1 plus S is here, does a helping verb. It is called do form helping verb. It is called V1. It is V1 plus S here, but it must become V1 in the negative. If you can understand this one only, you can understand it other negative sentence. Otherwise, everything will disappear. You practice this one, now it's on. Now, one more example. Nandini tells a story. Nandini tells a story. What is this? We don't learn answers suddenly. Jhatka gadi, slow, no bullet train. Slowly. Tells means V1 plus yes. Suddenly you must remember, recall what is the helping verb. What is helping verb? Very good. You know it better now. What is helping verb? Does. So, Nandini. What is helping verb? Does. What is the next word? Now. What is this? V1 plus S. What is required? V2 now. V3 now. Or V1 plus S? Only V1. It is the Maharaja. He is the king. Helping verbs are kings in our language. Preposition, big monster. Yeah. Nandini does not tell. Enough. Nandini does not tell a story. Next. Question mark should be there. No. It is a negative sentence. It is by my dear stars. You write only full stop. It will become negative sentence. It is the theme of understanding this one. Before I switch over to that interrogative sentence, my dear students, at least practice 5 to 6 sentences. Write this sentences as it is only. For example, I read a poem. I do not read a poem. I am reading a poem. I am not reading a poem. I have read a poem. I have not read a poem. I eat a banana. I do not eat a banana. I am eating a banana. I am not eating a banana. I have eaten a banana. I have not eaten a banana. I walk now. I do not walk. I am walking now. I am not walking now. I have walked now. I have not walked now. Please, my sincere request. Please, I humbly request you practice this one very well. If you do not practice this one now itself, that one will become very much confused. Please practice this one. Again, you start playing this video, learn the concept of interrogative sentence. Please. Okay? I hope that you will respect my words, you will follow my words. Thank you. I will proceed with the interrogative sentence. Now, I take a pen, I do not take a pen. I am taking a pen, I am not taking a pen. I have taken a pen, I have not taken a pen. I hope that this one has become very clear to you. I am very confident that you have become thorough and expert. You have become an expert in changing simple present tense only. Don't forget that thing. Don't think that I took a pen. Sir did not change this took a pen into negative or interrogative. No. Have patience for my class. Please wait. I do not take a pen. I am not taking a pen. I have not taken a pen. Now I will switch over to interrogative sentence. Interrogative sentence means what? Question sentences. If you want to understand the concept of interrogative, you must become an expert in this point, negative sentence. Now, Before switching over, I will give you some basic information under this category. What is this do form? What is this be one? What is this be form? What is this be one plus ing? What is this how form? What is this be three? You must understand. Like English is like the full of a formula, catchy and be bright. What is this do form? What is this be one? What is this be form? What is this be one plus ing? What is this how form? What is this how form plus be three? Now, what is the rule for a question? Yes or no type question. First of all, rule number 5. Rule number 5. What is the rule for changing one positive sentence into interrogative sentence? I am not saying this one. I am talking about how to change positive sentence into interrogative sentence. Now I will teach you only yes or no type question, not in the WH question. Okay. Now rule number 1. What is the rule number under rule number 5? Please remember and practice these rules again and again. It is not possible to practice next. Once you start coming to college, there is no time to you to practice these rules again and again. My colleagues also cannot help you because this topic is over. They will teach you the new concepts which are directly linked to the this board exam itself and the syllabus, current syllabus. This way, my dear students and little stars, practice this one. Rule number 5, under rule number 5, what is this rule? Under rule number 5, I will say, what is the formula? What is the formula to change one positive sentence into interrogative sentence? Yes or no type question itself. What is the formula? Be helping verb. Helping verb plus subject plus main verb plus subject complement. Now, once more, what is the formula for changing one positive sentence into interrogative or question sentence? Please, now, I am so happy that you are going to learn one more advanced topic and information in our English class. Please understand, memorize this one. It is your duty, whatever way you want to choose, selected, understand. What is the rule to change one positive sentence into interrogative sentence means first one must be helping verb, compulsory. Second one must be subject, compulsory. Third one must be main verb. Last subject complement. What is the meaning of subject complement? It is important. You have learned this one, but predicative, objective, predicative, subjective, predicative, and what? Objective, subjective, those days are over, my dear stars of Narayan Deo College. We are learning English in the highest level, maximum level. You take this one as subject complement. Means, after the verb, whatever it is, the subject complement, whether it is an object, whether it is a subject, it is unnecessary. Those all are bluff and blunders. We don't know how to make you learn this one. Well, it is why we always use predicate, subject, object, those are waste. Now, it is called a subject. Subject complement, subject complement, subject complement. After the verb, main verb, whatever it is there, it is called subject complement, including the object to, subject to, preposition, everything, articles, after the main verb, everything is called subject complement. Subject complement. It is, along this one, my colleagues and myself also, we teach this method in this order, in this method, in this style itself. It is better to you to learn this concept in this order. Once more I will say, What is the rule? Essential, important, most important rule to change one positive sentence into this interrogative be form. Yes or no type question means it is the rule. First one part, helping verb must be there. Next part, subject should be there. Next word, main verb must be there. Next word, subject complement. This is the rule. Now, because of learning this rule, it will become easier for you. What is easier? We have learned what is the helping verb. What is the helping verb? What did I say previously? Learning this one itself will help you to understand this interrogative sentence. Otherwise, everything will be confusing, confusing, confusing. Now, take this one. You are in take a pen. Learn how to change into negative. Do form. Take this one. First, take helping verb. Without changing that one into negative, you cannot understand. It is why take this one. First, do. I is here. Don't take subject as I. You must take you. Do you. What is the rule? We one. Do or does or take. We one. Do you take a pen? This is the rule. Yeah. I take a pen, I do not take a pen, do you take a pen? Right question mark. It is the biggest secret what you must learn. Yes, my dear stars, I will respond with two more examples. Remember the rule forever. How long you can remember the rule, that long you can write correct answers forever. My dear stars, understand the rules, understand this one thoroughly. Please, my request to you, don't learn so fast. It will never, 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 never work. Learn slowly. Even though you have learned this concept, learn it for once more. Then your English will remain in mind forever. Read, write, play the video, listen. And later, be confident. Until then, I have seen so many students learning so fast, forgetting so fast. Learning so fast and forgetting so faster. It is why, my dear stars, learn this one slowly. Practice this one. Next. I will explain these two sentences now. I am taking a pen. I am not taking a pen. What is the rule? Helping verb should be there. Another rule. Rule number 6. Whatever the type of helping verb is there in the negative sentence, same helping verb must be there. Rule number 6. I cannot write all the things. Please. What type of helping verb is there in the negative sentence? Same type should be there. If do form is there, do form. Be form is there, be form. Have form is there, have form. This is the law. Number 6. Once more. Do form as helping. Be form as helping. Have form, same. Three types, that's all. Be form, do form, have form. Only three types of helping words. It is more than enough for us. Okay, for me, for you may be required, you try it. Okay. Now, what is this be form? Here, one problem. I is not the subject in the question. Nanu hogutene, nanu hogudilla. Question. Nanu hogutina. No, 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 no. That is wrong. Neenu hogutiya. I will explain this one now. Do you take a pen? Now understand. Next method. Do you take a pen? Neenu pennu tagidukollutiya. Yes, I take a pen. Tagidukollutene. No. I do not take a pen. Take the code with the law. All rules are applied. No single word, no single rule is broken. It is why, my dear students, I will tell you three more examples. I speak English. I do not speak English. Do I speak English? No, 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 no. Do you speak English? How do you speak English? You
ಇಲ್ಲ ನಾನು ಹೋಗುವುದಿಲ್ಲ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ನಾನು ಹೋಗ್ತೀನ ನನ್ನ ಹೆಸರಿದ ನಾನು ಇಡ್ಲಿ ತಿನ್ನ ಇಟ್ ಲುಕ್ಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ಡ್ 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 ಡೋಂಟ್ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟಿಸ್ ದೋಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟಿಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಐ ಟೆಲ್ ಎ ಸ್ಟೋರಿ ಐ ಡೂ ನಾಟ್ ಟೆಲ್ ಎ ಸ್ಟೋರಿ ಡೂ ಯು ಟೆಲ್ ಎ ಸ್ಟೋರಿ ಐ ಡ್ರಿಂಕ್ ಕಾಫಿ ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಐ ಟೇಕ್ ಕಾಫಿ ನೋ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಐ ಡ್ರಿಂಕ್ ಕಾಫಿ ಐ ಡೂ ನಾಟ್ ಡ್ರಿಂಕ್ ಕಾಫಿ ಡೂ ಯು ಡ್ರಿಂಕ್ ಕಾಫಿ I tell a story. I do not tell a story. Do you tell a story? It is the concept, my dear little stars. Practice this one very well. I know it very well that you are so genius. All of you are wonderful stars of mine. Please practice. Be happy. Learn very happily. Don't take anything seriously. Be happy, relaxed and read. You can catch all the points very easily without any problem. Be happy and learn it well. Learn with fun. My motto, learn with fun. Relax. Now, first, what is this? Be form. But I is the subject, must become you. Why? You is here. Now, what is this? Be form. First you know, not you. What is this? Be form. What is this? Present tense. It is why are is the be form helping verb. For the subject you. Don't copy as it is. No, no, no. I is the subject, must become in the question are. What is this? Be form. What is this? Helping verb. Why be form is here? Are you? What is this? Main verb. Are you? A pen. Full stop. Correct? Oh, don't mistake me. Sir has written full stop. Wow, wow. I have caught the sir. He has written wrongly. No, no, no. My dear stars, I know that you are so intelligent and you are so alert. Okay. I will put question mark. Papa. Okay, na? Is it correct now? Okay. I am not taking a pen. B form is helping me. I am taking a pen is the positive sentence. Change into are you taking a pen? Question mark must be there. It is the concept of changing one. Positive present tense, positive sentence can be changed into interrogative sentence in this method. There is no other method in this whole English language. This is the law. You must learn in this order. There is no other method. It is the law of the English. My dear stars, learn this concept in this order. If you want to improve or refine your language, this is the law. Practice this one very well. Next. Why be form? Why be form is here? Why you question sentence? We were less ing. For example, I am running. Are you running? I am telling. Are you telling? I am laughing. Are you laughing? I am reading. Are you reading? See? Have wonderful and easily you are understanding now. You will never forget this whole session in your life. I know very well. I am so confident that you will never forget any rule in my all sessions. You are going to learn so many new things, my dear stars. I will make you perfect in my subject. I will give you the strongest promise. Next. I have not taken. What is this? Have form. Take have form only. Why? This I is here. You must make this one as have. What is subject? You. What is the verb? Have you taken a pen? This is the question. I have taken a pen. Have you taken a pen? Whatever the helping verb is there, you take it as it is. What is required for memorization? What is the rule book required? Do you need any grammar rule book now? Raymond Martin, that one, this one, wagera, that is over. My dear student, follow our teaching strictly. It is my duty to make you perfect in my subject. Now, I have not taken. First of all, I do not take, do you take? Why do form is here in the negative? Without changing this positive into negative, we cannot find this do. It is why I have taught first negative, later I have tried to change this one into interrogative sentence, question sentence.
What type of sentences interrogative to? Yes sir, no, that's all. I will explain WH questions later. Once more, I am not taking, are you taking? I have not taken, have you taken? Now, I love, do you love? I love, I do not love, do you love? I am laughing, I am not laughing, are you laughing? I have laughed, I have not laughed, have you laughed? I run, do you run? I go, do you go? I eat, do you eat? I write, do you write? I give, do you give? I see, do you see? That's all. Yes, my dear students, I am very confident. I am so delighted that you are learning these all things very happily. Please learn this one very well. Practice previous verbs, types of verbs, tenses. It is linked to directly first PUC and then later on second PUC. My each and every session is very essential to you, my dear stars of Narayanpur College. Please learn these all things again and again. Anyhow, I have 3 more days gap for the sake of the next session. Please, I sincerely, humbly request you, my dear staff, practice this one very well. I will teach you in my next session. I have found that I have to take one more session to make you understand past tense and future tense, because it is a base for first PC, second PC, degree for 4 sems. This way, my dear stars, I will happily teach you the concept of past tense, simple past tense. This one, positive sentence, negative sentence, interrogative sentence, in my next session, session number 5. Then you will become so perfect. Future will not trouble you, only this present tense and past tense will trouble us. Okay, this way. Okay, my dear students, I know it very well that you have understood this one very well, very easily. Practice this one for 2 more days. Write as many as possible. You write any 5 sentences, change into negative sentence, change into interrogative sentence, you will become perfect. I am confident that you will learn this one very well and do it well. I hope God bless you. Be happy and have a nice day. God bless you.